Hello and welcome to all our 1000 PS fans. I'm at the EICMA 2013, a very, very big motorcycle show, and a lot of accessories here too. Arai helmet, a very traditional brand, and I'm here with Sander van der Water, a sales manager from Arai, and he has a brand new helmet in his hands. It's a new motocross helmet. Sander, tell us something about this new helmet.
Yeah, this is indeed a complete new motocross helmet of Arai. When you look at this helmet, we call it the MX-V. It's evolved from the previous model, the VX3. When you take a good look at the helmet, you still can see the round and smooth shape of the Arai helmet. And that is, we do that by purpose. Sometimes you hear people say, why does Arai not make helmets with strange scoops and edges? No, the helmet must be as round as possible in order to glance off obstacles. It's all about safety. Because when the helmet is sliding and glance off obstacles, you also divert the energy, the impact energy before it reaches your head. So this is very important.
So you think all the helmets with these things is show? That's all nothing but show?
Yeah, it doesn't have a real function.
Okay.
And we call this also the R75 concept. It's not a concept what Arai invented, but it was already mandatory in the Japanese standards and also in the BSI when you had the BSI standards in the UK. And that means that the helmet must have a continuous round curve of minimum of 75 millimeters. And we have here some kind of tool that can show you that it always have to be within this radius of 75 millimeters. And then it is round enough to keep on sliding.
Okay, okay.
This is all plastic parts. So when you have a crash, it always will break off. So that is the reason why we use plastic parts. Well, you look at the shell. It's made of SCLC construction, which is a super fiber specially made by Arai, which is 40% stronger than standard fiber material. So also twice as expensive, unfortunately. Well, the configuration of the shell, you can see a very hyper ridge here. And this means that also the helmet's center of gravity is very low.
Okay.
And that is important because averagely Arai helmets are a little bit more heavy than you can find with other brands on the market.
Yes.
Because we do not want to make any concessions in the thickness and strongness of the shell, because it has to glide and sustain impact energy. So the shell is strong everywhere, but the center of gravity is very low. So if you wear the helmet, you don't feel any stress on your neck. So that's important. And look at the ventilation, it's a very good ventilated helmet. The peak is not only meant to catch the mud and the flying objects, it also gives a venturi effect over the helmet. So the hot air will be extracted from the top and from the back of the helmet. You can see here two slots, and the cold air comes in and the hot air will be extracted from the helmet.
So in the back there is a new aerodynamic
effect, yes. And also these lower side ducts create a low air pressure behind the helmet. So also this creates a vacuum which extracts the hot air. So you can also remove all the ducts. Easy to clean because you can see right through them. We have here a few slots, which also gives a lot of air pressure, or not air pressure, but fresh air when you wear the goggles. You still have wind behind the goggles. That's also for anti-fogging. The front is new. You can also remove it completely. And the iron mesh is mounted from the outside, so also penetration resistant.
Okay.
Before that, it was mounted from the inside, so it can easily be pressed in. You can also open and close the front vent. When you ride in dusty situation, it's always possible to close it. Well, the complete interior you can take out. So also the neck pad you can completely take out and clean it, of course. This material is made of dry cool, so very efficiently material to absorb sweat and moisture.
And like not so much smell.
Yeah, indeed. And also, like the VX3 we had, and with some other helmets, the emergency release cheek pad. When you crash, you need the helmet to get off early or quickly. You just press on and the cheek pad goes out.
Okay.
Yeah? So that is a feature we already had in a previous helmet also. Then we have a fascia contour system. This is a cheek pad with a foam spring inside. When you put the helmet on, it compresses, and when the helmet is on, it bounces back. And give a good snug fit on the jaw area instead of on the cheek area. So yeah, this is basically the most features. You have here the cockle band guidance also between the ducts. It will be fitted quite firmly.
So it won't lose the position.
Sorry?
So it won't lose the position.
Indeed, yeah. It will be available in springtime. So and also
What about the color schemes, colors?
Yeah, we are working on some stunning designs, of course, and these will be available also in springtime. This is still the first samples for the show.
But, yeah. So very much technology inside. And what about the price? Could you tell us?
Oh, that's a good one, because it's so new. Really, we still have to define the price. It will be available, the price, within a few days, and then we can communicate.
It's okay, because it won't be cheap, but it will be very, very good and very professional.
The same level as all our helmets, of course.
Thank you, Sander, for the interview, and much fun at the EICMA 2013.
Welcome. Yeah, thank you very much. Okay.